Good evening, chat. The good folks in my audience really liked the format of my last video, so let's try it again. 2023 is probably gonna get remembered as a bad year for pop music on the whole, and I understand why, but there were so many great songs that blew up this year that were actually starting with... I might be honest, not the best idea. The hook's instantly memorable, those guitars are excellent for fleshing out the atmosphere with the distant keys, and SZA's performance is both infectiously playful while also convincing you that, yeah, she absolutely can and will kill her ex if she's serious. And who's to say she isn't? La cana bailando sola me gusta pa mi. This is the song that made me get Sierreños as one of the defining sounds of 2023. Blissfully infectious chemistry, dudes rock. It's the 4th of July. You're going down Massachusetts 28 in an old-ass convertible. You're heading back from an unauthorized fireworks show that just got shut down by the cops. You can see the clouds of fog in the headlights. You are blasting this song, and you are having the time of your fucking life. It only makes sense for a song about the worth of one's passion to feel so enrapturing and timeless. I ain't proud of all the punches that I've thrown in the name of someone I no longer know. I find most of Noah Kahan's music to be pretentious, ballsless, stomp, clap, hey shit, and Dial Drunk isn't not that, but it's also got a real driving hook, and Post Malone's exactly the right guest to put this song into overdrive. Cold shoulder, closing time, you bring me to stay till the sun rolls. As gorgeous as it is devastating. Yes, I know that he's my ex, we can't do me what we connect. I only see him as a friend, biggest lie I ever said. Olivia Rodrigo's biggest strength as an artist, at least in my book, is her in-song acting. And this is easily the best example of that. Every fragment of the second verse alone is iconic. Don Periño le haga lentes en la cara. Even more infectious dudes rock energy. Just a heartbroken bitch, high heels, 6 inch in the back of the nightclub, sipping champagne. I'm absolutely floored. Phenomenal storytelling through the writing, performance, and production, gripping and dragging you by the collar through the panic, ecstasy, and heartbreak of the night. In a normal year, this would be number one by a landslide. But the currents of TikTok had other plans, and as such... There was no real competition. This is one of my favorite songs of all time. Kaliuchis's hook is obviously fantastic, but I really love how Tyler's voice bounces and blooms over the gorgeous string and horn arrangements. It's as cinematic as it is intimate. There's nothing I love more than a song that feels like its own beautiful world, and this is exactly that. Now, with how many songs on this list made only the V30 year-end chart and not Billboard's, one might ask, is the V30 just always better? That was a real question I had going into 2024, and I can confidently say that the answer is absolutely fucking not.